The 10th presenter for today is Zeinab Farhat, who's a PhD student in epidemiology and environmental health in the School of Public Health and Health Professions. The title of her 3MT presentation is Garlic's Role as an Antioxidant in Cancer. She enjoys going to concerts, cooking, baking, and doing puzzles, and she's both an avid fan of the New York Giants, which is okay, and iced coffee. So, ready, set, pitch.
Has anyone ever told you to eat garlic when you're sick or to use garlic to treat an infection? That's because garlic is a superfood that has been used since ancient times, but only recently we've begun to understand its wide range of health benefits. Garlic contains active compounds such as amino acids, vitamins, minerals, and over 33 sulfur compounds, which we can attribute those health benefits to. One such health benefit is its anti-cancer activity, which is the focus of my dissertation project. About one-third of all cancer deaths in the United States could be avoided through appropriate dietary changes. And garlic is a cancer-preventing food that has the ability to trap, block, and suppress cancer-causing agents from leading to cancer. Garlic can act by capturing molecules known as free radicals that can roam around in the cell, causing damage to our DNA and ultimately leading to cancer. Or it can act by directly killing cancer cells. These free radicals are angry molecules that can arise from sources such as cigarette use, alcohol use, air pollution exposure, stress, and drug use. If we have too many of these free radicals roaming around in the cell, this can lead to a dangerous phenomenon known as oxidative stress. This phenomenon can be counteracted by antioxidants like garlic because they can capture these free radicals and prevent them from causing DNA damage. The first part of my dissertation focuses on utilizing data from a large nationwide human study that collected information on people's garlic intake and supplement use and followed them for a period of time to see whether or not they got cancer or they died from cancer. What we found was that garlic supplement use for 3 or more years could prevent against any cancer development. However, the challenge with epidemiological or human studies is that the biologically active compounds in garlic could differ depending on the type of garlic form that's eaten or how it's prepared. So I set out to test the antioxidant and anti-cancer activity of several garlic forms, including fresh garlic, cooked garlic, garlic powder, and 2 commercially available garlic supplements. What we found was that garlicin, which is a garlic supplement and contains predominantly garlic powder, had the ability to have high antioxidant activity and had the ability to kill cancer cells in lung cancer cell lines. The next part of my project was to administer this garlicin supplement to a group of healthy volunteers here at UB in a clinical trial and measure their antioxidant activity in the blood over a period of 6 weeks. Ultimately, we hope to translate these findings to cancer patients and promote garlic as a part of the regular healthy diet. Thank you.
I have to admit that presentation made me a little hungry.